Hey, now there's something I've been noticing in my own behaviour when I'm on the train or a bus or at a cafe and I hear half of a conversation. It drives me crazy.
Did you hear? Yeah, Matt said it's embargoed until next week. All right, I'm on my way to the airport.
So why is that? Now, there's something about hearing a one-sided conversation like this that makes us intensely curious. Well, this is actually called a halfalogue. Halfalogues are a fascinating window into how our brains work. We have this desire to fill in the blanks. We experience a sudden urge of curiosity when we feel a gap between what we know and what we want to know. This is called the information gap. When we get information, but just a small part of it, we crave more. But as we get more and more information, after a certain point, our curiosity starts to decline. So where does this sudden desire for information even come from? Well, it turns out that curiosity is one of the hardest things for philosophers, psychologists, or neuroscientists to explain. There are hints that we come with a primal curiosity circuit in the brain that's probably shared with many other animals. In this circuit is an area called the caudate nucleus. It's involved in anticipating reward coming from more primal things like food, sex, and drugs in the form of tiny spikes of dopamine, which makes you feel fantastic. But researchers have also found when we're faced with a trivia question, we have a surge of activity in this area. Perhaps that explains my addiction to Jeopardy. But instead of giving you your well-deserved reward, halfalogues abuse this circuit by their incessant cliffhangers. Good cliffhangers manipulate you by inducing a delightful sense of anticipation and joy. But not getting the information you crave for can leave you frustrated. Your brain is, unconsciously, constantly making predictions about what should happen next. In the case of halfalogues, it's predicting to hear the response to what you just heard. But if you never do, it's like an itch that doesn't get scratched. Hearing halfalogues can ruin your daily commute, just like how unresolved cliffhangers can ruin a great TV show. Because sources of incomplete information have such a stronghold on our attention, some think it might mean open workspaces are not the best idea for productivity. But studies that have measured performance on simple tasks in the presence of halfalogues haven't been conclusive so far. Sure, halfalogues might be annoying, but the curiosity that they evoke is helpful and even enjoyable. Curiosity promotes learning. Studies have found that when we're more curious to find out an answer, we're more likely to remember what that answer is. So perhaps all that boring class needs is just a good cliffhanger. Think about it. But wait, there's a bit more. This is actually the first episode of two that I'm doing on curiosity, and there's more reasons about why we are curious. The next episode answers an important question that you've been wondering for a long time. What if